Start recording. Stop recording. Button.
What's up, YouTube? It's me, Rashid Blind Perspective. I'm not even sure what to title this video. Yes, Introduction to Baofeng UV5R. So, this is you watched me unbox this yesterday. So, what I will do now is I'm going to give you a physical description of the radio. So when you get the radio, you will need to install the battery. It goes in one way, obviously. And the antenna. Now the antenna only goes on one way. The antenna is called a rubber duck antenna. I still don't know why, because it doesn't seem to be made of rubber. But you take it and you screw it on. Only goes on one way. And screw it on like so. And you have your antenna on now. I'm going to give you a physical description of this radio. Now, when I unboxed it, the AC adapter that I found. What happens is, at the very bottom of the box, I didn't find this at first, at the very bottom is a base, a drop-in base. It almost reminds me of, you know, one of those base stations for home phones, for house phones, landlines. And the AC adapter, the wire itself, plugs into the back of it, and you take the radio and you put it in the base. But the important thing to do is make sure that the radio is all the way towards the back of the radio. And there's a very small slot where the battery should go, because there are little charging contacts, I guess, at the very bottom of the radio. So I'll let you hear what it sounds like when you put it in. I almost knocked it over, but I'll let you hear the noise here. And you want to have it in there and make sure it doesn't wiggle a lot. And then taking it out is just as easy. Now, I'll drop it in there just to let you hear what it sounds like right now. And I'll take it out. You can hear what it sounds like. And it's just as easy. Now I'll give you a physical description. It's a rectangular device, the radio itself is. On the top left is where the antenna goes in. You'll need to install your antenna. I already did that. To the right of that, you have a knob. It's sort of like a knob for an old television set, where you turn it, it turns the radio on, and you turn it more, the volume goes up. On the face, at the very top, you have a screen. Below that, you have a button. At the very towards the left, you have one button. It is it says VFO/AR, but it changes the mode between channel mode and frequency mode. I'll go into that later on. Below that you have a very small button. It's recessed. I don't know what the button does. But then you have the speaker, and then below that you have a row. The one button on each side of the row. The button on the left is the the AB button. This changes your VFO. You actually have two of them, so it's like having two readers at once. You could be listening to two things at once, but I wouldn't recommend this. To the right of that, you have the band button. This switches between, I think, VHF, UHF, and all that fun stuff. Below that, you have four rows of four buttons. And the top row on the left, you have menu. To the right of that, you have up. To the right of that, you have down. To the right of that, you have exit. The next row down, you have, on the far left, you have one. To the right of that, you have two. To the right of that, you have three. To the right of that, you have star. The next row on the far left, you have four. Right of that, you have five. To the right of that, you have six. To the right of that, you have zero. The next row down, On the far left, you have 7. To the right of that, you have 8. To the right of that, you have 9. To the right of that, you have pound. That's it for the buttons. On the right side, you have a little flap that opens up. And you open it up. And you have a headphone jack. And I believe a microphone jack. Don't quote me on that, but supposedly there's a serial port on here somewhere to connect it to a computer and program it. I didn't pick up the programming cable. I'm just going to do it manually. But I don't know how to program it yet, what to press and what not to. But I do... there's a booklet that comes with it. I'll try and get some reason to read it out or something. Maybe I'll do a little bit of research on these radios. But let's just turn this radio on here. Actually, no, I forgot about the left side of the radio. So on the left side, you have 3 buttons. At the very top, you have the call button. And if you press this, it goes to an FM radio. And then if you press it again, it goes back to the ham band or whatever, the actual UHF, VHF, and all that, whatever. Below that, you have your PTT, which means the push-to-talk. It's a long button, and you hold it down to transmit. It's sort of, you know, and then you let it go. But this, to transmit, you need a license. You don't need a license to listen to stuff. I'm planning on getting a license this summer when school lets out, in June maybe. But anyways, below the PTT is the monitor button. So, let me go into detail about this. When you're listening to a frequency, or whatever, when somebody is talking, you hear it through the speaker. When they release, what you hear, what you would hear is just static. But there's a thing on this radio called a squelch, which filters out the static. So you don't have to hear it all the time. Like, for example, you know. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to turn this radio on. I'm going to turn the knob and also that will turn the volume up, and you'll hear the following.
Mode.
All right, you heard that? Now I'm going to switch my mode here to channel mode.
Channel mode.
And then you can use your up and down arrows to move through the channels. I don't have anything programmed yet, but it'll still read the numbers out.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 0. One.
Kind of sounds cool, but yeah, you can program stuff on this. I don't have anything programmed yet, but you can program, I think, 120 channels in this. So I'm going to go back to channel 1.
1, 0, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And I'm going to go into frequency mode, and then I'm going to type 162.550. Now, when you type frequencies, there is no decimal point, so you just type it in here. So I'm going to go to frequency and type 162.550. So here we go.
Frequency mode. 1, 6, 2, 5, 5, 0.
An hour gusting to 17 in South Lake Tahoe.
And there's my weather station.
42.
This thing is always transmitting, obviously.
9 miles an hour. Reno, Nevada, under cloudy skies. Temperature 53 degrees.
This does get quite loud, so.
North wind at 9 miles an hour. The forecast for the southern Sacramento Valley, including the cities of Sacramento and Davis today, mostly cloudy. Highs 64 to 70. Southwest winds up to 10 miles.
I'm just going to type a random frequency for it to stop talking.
Mostly clear.
So.
Lows around
1, 6 to 10 miles. 2.
Monday.
4.
Sunny in the morning.
5.
Cloudy.
6.
Alright. Now I'll show you the FM radio here. I'll press the call button and we'll hear a bunch of static. But one thing to note, I'm going to turn the radio off for a minute here. One thing to note is that when you're entering frequencies on the FM part and you hear the audio, the static or whatever, You can't really hear what you're entering, so you have to be really good at this keypad stuff. So I'll turn the radio back on here and press the call button.
Frequency mode.
And by default, it'll be at 87.5. So I'm going to hit call. And you hear lovely static. Oh, I hate that noise. Now I'm going to type 100. Or no, I'm going to type 100100. And you won't really be able to hear the thing telling me what I'm typing. So here we go. And there you have it. I'll turn the volume down because this stuff is copyright, of course, but I'll let you hear the speaker a little bit. And there you have it. I'll type just 104.1 and 105.5 just to give you an idea what it's like to tune around. And there you have it. I'll type 104.1 just because I feel like it. And there's the classic rock station, 104.1 Hawk in Stockton, California. I'll hit the call button to get back to the UHF, VHF, and all that. And here we are. The monitor button is just if you're talking to somebody over satellite and you want to... You can't really hear them very well and your squelch is just not... your filter's not going on. You can just hit monitor and then it'll just open it up completely. So I'll do that now. At least it's supposed to, anyways. Well, I don't know what that's all about. I'm just gonna turn the rate. I'm gonna hit exit. That's kind of fun. I'll just type random numbers.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2. Cancel. 1, 2, 3, 0. Zero.
I'll go to the menu here to show you what it's like.
Menu.
And use the up arrow. And I'll go to channel mode.
Channel mode. 2, 1, 1, 2, 7. 2, 1, 2, 0. 2, 1.
Well, I'm using my up arrow.
1, 2, 7.
Well, I have no idea what I just did. I arrowed about 28 times. I hit menu. And then it said receiving memory or something like that. I hit confirm again, or menu again, and then it said transmitting memory. I hit menu again, and then I hit menu again, and it said transmitting memory. I hit menu again, and then I hit exit. Well, I'm going to try and delete it now. So it's number 28. So I'm going to hit menu, and then I'm going to hit up arrow 29 times.
Channel mode.
Menu. 29 times up.